So, yeah, welcome to Visual Studio. Basically, I've already hit a breakpoint, so we're in debug mode right now. And I think what's interesting about the Visual Studio debugger, and is something that I know the team we've been trying to work on for a long time now, is just making a lot of those cool tools more discoverable. So while there's a lot that's present at first glance, there's also a lot of tools that I'm probably going to show off later that are hidden away behind some context menu or something else that can be hard to find. So that's the downside to the debugger. But once you do discover them, they're really useful. So to give a general tour, you've got your stepping icons here. So you got step into, step over, step out. You have your inspection windows, which I use a lot to inspect all of your related variables and stuff like that.
Okay.
And of course, you have your breakpoints. You have your execution pointer, which you can actually drag and move around, which I can show off definitely. And so I guess to give an example of a hidden tool that I use a lot is, so just for context, I have this .NET Core application here. It's a web app. I like to read, so it will give me a list of books that I can choose to read and add to a shelf, or choose to reject, and they won't be added to my shelf. And I have this breakpoint that's set up at one of my early constructor methods called book manager. And let's say I wanted to navigate to the bottom of this function just to see that all of these books get loaded into this neutral books array properly. So usually this might be the time where I might have to start spamming the step over button or F10 in order to get down there. And that's not going to be fun because I got this for loop that's coming up here, and I could be stuck in that for loop for who knows how long. So an alternative that I use all the time is this feature called run to click. So you'll notice this green glyph icon that appears when I hover over a line. So if I click that, then it should take me. So it fast forwards my code's execution all the way up to that point. It's like having a fast forward button on a remote control.
I dig it. And that then solves that problem that we were talking about earlier about, like, now I have to walk through, you know, eight things that now I can just go,
right,
go here, do this.
Exactly. Exactly. And it's really the little things. I use that one a lot. So there's features like that. One of my other features that I enjoy, so we've got a data tip here. So a lot of the time you can hover over a variable and view all the related variable information or all of its contents and things like that. And in my case, I pinned one already. So pretend you don't see this right now. I'm going to show you something cool. Usually when you open up a collection or an IR enumerable or an item like that, right, you might try to inspect that particular array and you'll just get the generic type information. That's not very useful, right? So if you wanted to know if you would like to quickly identify each of these books in this case by its title property, for instance, all you have to do is navigate to which property you want to view first and then pin it. I call this pinnable properties, and it will be bubbled up to the top of your list. And then as you can see, if I hover over again, it's a lot more useful information right at first glance instead of having to expand each of these out until you find the right one. And this is applicable to all of the different inspection windows that the debugger has. So I can expand this one out and see the same results. I can pin multiple properties and identify that way. So it's a really nice way to do it, because an alternative that was used before this tool was just, I mean, you could modify your toString method for a particular class. But if you do that, that could impact your program itself. If you want to keep the separation between what's being displayed in your debugging environment versus what's being displayed in your program proper, you may not want to override your toString method with that debugging related info. So So that was one thing that came about. And then the evolution of overriding the toString method turned into another attribute called debugger display, which I have commented out here. But this was a tool where you could append something like this to the top of your class definition, and it would let you do the same thing that those pins did, which let you view those specific properties in the debugging environment.
Okay.
And yeah. Anyway, the problem with something like that, though, is that IntelliCode's not really going to tell you that this exists. Or actually, I believe it, I think some refactorings do tell you that nowadays, which is cool. But if you're not actively seeking this out, it can be really hard to find. You still have to modify your code in order to use that. And you don't want to modify our code to debug things. My goodness. So, yeah, and that's where the pin properties came from. So pin properties, it actually came from hearing customer sentiment. So I'd been doing tips and tricks debugging talks for a bit, and a lot of people would ask about Debugger Display, which is always a hit at these talks, like, wow, is this new to Visual Studio 2019? Like, no, apparently this thing has existed since, like, I don't know, 2013 or earlier than that.
Really? So,
yes.
I'm now learning this for the first time right now. Like, I had no idea that that attribute was there. Like, I've done that two string in the past, and it's like, it didn't quite, it didn't feel good, but at least it worked.
Right. So, it's a workaround. It's like,
yeah.
I don't feel that great about it, but it gets the job done, you know? So this one with pinnable properties, you can feel good about what you're doing, knowing that it's not going to impact your program proper, and still get the same result. So